Masa apa? Masa my style. Apa khabar anda semua di sana? How is everyone? I hope everybody is doing fine. Saya harap anda semua sihat walafiat Anda semua baik. Hari ini saya tak akan cakap banyak-banyak. I won't talk so long because a lot of preparation to do. So this has a lot of people who wanted to see and wanted to know how to do this. Banyak orang telah request, mohon untuk tengok macam mana nak buat laksa Johor. This is laksa, laksa Johor, the Johor laksa or whatever laksa they call, the Malay laksa, okay? So let me show you to my sort of like a vegetarian laksa, okay? Saya tunjukkan barang-barang untuk dia kisar dulu These are all things that for blended first Bawang, bawang putih, halia, udang kering, cili kering dan juga ikan kembung So this is mackerel or ikan kembung, I don't know what it's called, I can't remember right now So onions, garlic and ginger and then dry prawns and dry chili and then we will I will add a krisik and of course this is a coconut paste and then santan and also tamarind pulp so this is all for the gravy okay rempah kari ikan saya pakai kari ikan faizan so all this we blend first You also blend the dry prawns udang kering juga blend Then we also blend the dry chili kita blenderkan sekali chili kering ni Hari tu kita rebus dulu ikan kembung ni We cook first we boil first this fish this okay, kita rebus ikan ni bersama asam keping so we boil this fish with the tamarind pulp okay air jangan buang take the fish out the water the fish stock don't throw away so kita kopek kopek ikan ni Okay, tulang-tulang dia kita buang lah Throw away the bones Then Put in the blender And then Take a bit of the fish stock Ambilkan air ikan sikit Untuk kisar Ini bahan-bahan yang untuk dimasak kuah So these are all after I blend everything This is for the gravy So the curry powder, fish curry powder The coconut paste, the tamarind pulp Dry prawn onions, garlic and ginger and then dry chili and the fish just now that I boil tu dia barang-barang untuk yang saya buat kuah yang ikan rebus cili kering, bawang-bawang putih halia udang kering asam keping dan juga krisik ni untuk kuah dia this is for the gravy dan santan juga tak lupa minyak kita boil and then put in your onion, garlic and ginger okay, tumis ni semua bau dia dah naik I can smell the fragrance already put in your curry powder masukkan air sikit put a bit of water and then put in the chili paste. Saya semangkukkan eh. So it's the same amount lah of this small bowl. Tumis sehingga naik bau eh. I can smell already ya. Masukkan udang kering. Put in your dry prawn. Okay, lepas tu dah bau dah naik eh. Masukkan santan. Put in your coconut milk. This pot is for 2 liter. So I use 2 box of coconut milk. Perut ni untuk 2 liter eh. Okay, masukkan krisik. Coconut paste, asam keping, tamarind pulp, and the fish paste. And then you add water. Saya tambah fish stock tadi eh. Sikit eh. Campurkan ni. Masak eh. And masukkan garam, salt. Okay, hampir masak eh. Okay, this is how it should be like sejohor. Then you put in a little bit of your bunga kantan. And then a bit of kesum leaf, laksa leaf, just to have a flavor of it ah. Then later you can garnish it with the rest of the noodles. Barang-barang hiasannya daun kesum, laksa leaf and then I use taupok dry tofu, carrots, long beans and then bunga kantan and cucumber all shredded eh. Jadi saya hiris-hiris ni bawa apa ni limon dengan carrot, lobak merah dan juga sayur kacang panjang di dadukan kecil-kecil ini. Ini terserah pada awak eh. Bunga kantan, daun kesum dan juga saya pakai tahu kering eh dan limau eh. Okey. Itu saja. And last but not least, yang terakhir masukkan taupok ni eh. Tahu kering eh. Itu dia laksa Johor my style. Amboi, sedap. Caranya saya pakai mi laksa eh. Awak boleh pakai mi spaghetti juga eh, terserah. And then wah, nampak sedap eh. Kepada yang baru-baru nak belajar tu taklah leceh sangat eh, cuma a lot of preparation eh. To those who just started to learn how to wanted to learn to make this, it's not that difficult but just a lot of preparation. And then the rest of the ingredients. And then I love this bunga kantan eh. And I so love this daun kesum ah. Very nice smell eh. Saya suka daun kesum dan bunga kantan ni eh. Komen sedap eh. Ni kita makan dengan sambal belacan eh. So this is laksa Johor my style. Kita sama kembali kepada sesi cekik menyekik makan memakan eating session time. Oh wow. Ini dia eh. Laksa Johor yang bukan main cantik lagi eh. Okay, this is my style. Saya makan dengan sambal belacan ni eh. Saya beli di Sheng Siong. Memang sedap eh. Anda pun boleh makan dengan sambal belacan sirin eh. Saya pun dah pernah tunjuk dulu. I've already shown you. You can eat with this sambal belacan. It's very 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 wonderful. Okay, itu dia. Saya sipat cekik punya kek ni. Memang orang all time favorite eh. Hmm. Okay, I love the daun kesum. I love the laksa leaf. I put a little bit additional laksa leaf which I want, and then my sambal and everything. Oh wow, nampak macam cantik eh. And bunga kantan and everything and the sambal. Alamak. You can put bean sprout eh, awak boleh taruh tauge kalau awak nak. If you want, you can put bean sprout. I'm not a bean sprout lover, so it's completely up to you eh. Optional, okay. Bismillah. I love the topok. You can put siham, fish cake, quail eggs. Eh, awak boleh taruh telur burung, fish cake, apa-apa lah. Up to you. It's completely up to you what you want to put. It's very very sedap. Easy to make, but for you first beginning beginners will take a bit of time because preparation . But if you got maid, easy lah. Kalau awak ada pembantu rumah, senang . Wah, sedap. Marvelous. Tak payah keluar beli laksa . Wow. I'm finishing in less than 10 minutes. Very good. Sungguh sedap . Sambal belacan ni pun sedap . I'll show you already. If you put the taupok, so be careful, the taupok is a bit salty . Sampai lupa nak berbual. I'm telling you, I'm finishing the whole entire plate. Ada bunga kantan. That one is for 2 liter pot lah. Yang pot yang sederhana . Kalau awak pot kecil, ikan tu 2 ekor je. If a small pot, the fish can do 2 pieces lah . No need so much of the fish . Kan dia tak payah banyak . First time break record, I finish my whole entire plate. Okay, break record for the video, alright? So, it's a very nice laksa Johor paling sedap . Saya pun habis makan ni dengan video secepat ini . Okay, so I see you all again on Masak Apa Masak My Style. Bye-bye.